which is day today?
8th of August 2024.
Which is day today?
Thursday.
Today I am going to teach you the new topic in the English grammar. What is that topic name?
Sentences.
Do you know the spelling of sentences?
Yes, E-N-T-E-N-C-E-S.
First of all, in the last year we had taken another topic. It is related with the sentences, but these are the structural types. And tell me the definition of sentence first.
A sentence is a group of words which make complete sense.
Okay, so tell me their types.
Declarative sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, exclamatory sentence, or optative sentence.
Okay, but in this lesson, in this topic, we will take the structural types. So, do you know? Tell after me. Simple sentence.
Simple sentence.
Compound sentence.
Compound sentence.
And complex sentence.
And complex sentence.
Understood?
Yes, teacher.
Once again, you have to revise it.
Simple sentence, compound sentence, complex sentence.
Okay. For example, Ricky is studying with me. This is the simple sentence. Which type of sentence is this?
Simple sentence.
Now, I am going to tell you the definition of simple sentence. A simple sentence contains a subject, verb pair. It expresses a complete thought. Once again, you can read, Ankita.
A simple sentence contains a subject, verb pair. It expresses a complete thought.
Which pair is you have to see in this definition? Subject and verb pair. I am going to explain through an example. Ricky is studying with me. Which is the subject in this sentence?
Ricky.
And which is the verb in this sentence?
Is studying.
Understood?
Yes.
Once again, you can read, Ankita. Simple sentence definition.
Simple sentence contains a subject verb pair. It expresses a complete thought.
Understood?
Yes.
Understood?
Yes, teacher.
Kanna, you can understand?
Yes, teacher.
Oh. Next, another topic is compound sentence. Tell me the spelling of compound sentence.
C-O-M-P-O-U-N-D, compound. S-E-N-T-E-N-C-E, compound
okay.
Sentence.
Compound sentence. Now, the definition of compound sentence is a compound sentence contains two simple sentences joining by a comma plus a conjunction. So, first of all, I am going to explain the term of conjunction. Do you know the definition of conjunction?
A conjunction is a word used to join words or sentences.
Understood?
Yes, teacher.
Next, such as, say after me, A and D.
And
B-U-T
but
O-R
or
S-O
so
Y-E-T
yeah
F-O-R
for
N-O-R
nor.
These are the examples of some conjunction. What are these?
Conjunction.
Okay. Now it is look at this sentence. Ricky is studying with me and I am helping him. Once again, you can read.
Ricky is studying with me and I am helping him.
In this sentence, Ricky is studying with me and I am helping him are joined by a conjunction. Thus, it is a compound sentence. Which is the conjunction here?
And.
And which conjunction join these two sentences?
And.
A and D?
And.
So, it is called a compound sentence. Once again, I repeat the definition of compound sentence. So, say after me, a compound sentence.
A compound sentence.
Contains.
Contains.
Two simple sentences.
Two simple sentences.
Joined by.
Joined by.
A comma.
A comma.
Plus a conjunction.
Plus a conjunction.
In this sentence, do you see the comma? Yes.
Yes.
And conjunction A and D.
And.
Understood this term?
Yes, teacher.
Which term we had learned now?
Compound sentence.
Okay. Now I am going to teach you the third last kind. It is the complex sentence. a complex sentence contains a simple sentence combined with a group of words that cannot stand alone as an independent sentence. Understood? Once again, you can repeat after me. A complex sentence.
A complex sentence.
Contains a.
Contains a.
Simple sentence.
Simple sentence.
Combined with a.
Combined with a.
Group of words.
Group of words.
That cannot stand.
That cannot stand.
Alone.
Alone.
As an. Independent sentence.
Independent sentence.
Next point is the group of words is dependent on the simple sentence to make its meaning clear. Now, here one example is there. For example, Ricky studies with me when he is confused. Tell me which is the simple sentence in this sentence.
Ricky studies with me.
And which is the independent sentence in this sentence?
When confused.
In this sentence, Ricky studies with me is a simple sentence, whereas the remaining part of the sentence, so when he is confused, it is the independent sentence. So in this sentence, which is the independent sentence? When he is confused. Which is the simple sentence? Ricky studies with me. Hence, this whole sentence, it is a complex
sentence.
Do you understand the example of complex sentence?
Yes, teacher.
I will tell you the definition of subordinating conjunction. What is the meaning of subordinating conjunction? Do you know the spelling of subordinating conjunction?
S-U-B-O-R-D-I-N-A-T-I-N-G.
Okay. Did you get it?
Yes.
Now I am going to tell you the definition. Subordinating conjunctions are words that appear in complex sentences. Where it appears?
In complex sentences.
At the beginning of the group of words that does not express a complete thought. Here, for example, subordinating conjunctions example. Although her baby was ugly, Mama Monkey was very proud of him. Which is the subordinating conjunction in this sentence?
Although.
What is the spelling of although?
A-R-T-H-O-U-G-L.
Once again, repeat it.
A-L-T-H-O-U-G-L.
Although. It is the compound conjunction. It is the compound
conjunction.
Here. It is the subordinating conjunction.
Conjunction.
Understood?
Yes.
And it appears beginning of the sentences.
Yes.
So, dear children, do you understand the kinds of sentences?
Yes, teacher.
So, which are the structural kinds of sentences?
Simple sentence, compound sentence, complex sentence.
Understood?
Yes, teacher.
So, you have to memorize it in home. Tomorrow, I will ask you each and every definition.
Yes.
Okay, goodbye, dear students.
Goodbye, teacher. Bye, teacher. Bye.